Hey guys, what's up? So in this lesson I'll talk about right to information and higher judiciary, and it is a very important concept. People have been asking about me what is RTI Act and how does it apply to court, and because definition of public authority, it includes them. So let us see. So RTI Act definitely applies to courts because they are obviously included in the definition of public authority. And what do you mean by public authority? So RTI Act define public authority in section 2H. okay. So public authority means any authority or body or institution of self-government which is established or constituted either under the constitution, by the constitution, okay. So Supreme Court, all these are under constitution. By any other law made by parliament, so again that is public authority. By any other law made by state legislature, by notification issued or order made by the appropriate government. And it also includes any body owned, controlled or substantially financed by the government, or the non-governmental organization which is substantially financed directly or indirectly by funds provided by the appropriate government. So that is the definition of public authority. Now most high courts did not even appoint public information officers even months after the act came into force. So this effectively denied the right to information. So this is a very big issue. Since high courts are public authority under that, they should have appointed public information officer. If any citizen of India wants information, so obviously there has to be some procedure for that. There should be a point of contact, and for that you need PIO. But unfortunately, they did not do, even after months of this act being implemented. So obviously this will deny the rights to the citizen to get information from the courts. So those which appointed PIOs have framed their own rules which effectively deny the information to the public. So they are doing their own rules and regulations. So High Court rules have increased the application fees from the normal 10 rupees to 500 rupees, and the penalty for non-disclosure, it has been reduced from maximum of 25,000 as provided in the act to rupees 500. 500 rupees will not deter any officer, right? They must be getting salary of 50,000, 60,000. So they are earning 2,000 rupees per day. Unko 500 rupees penalty lag bhi gayi, so nothing will happen to them. So it is not a deterrent to any information officer from denying information. So every attempt has been made to dilute the act by dilution of penalty and to make it as difficult as possible for citizens to access information about the courts. So this was the brief background which everybody should know before we start to see the case. Now let's see the Subhash Chandra Agarwal case. So what happens in this case is court's reluctance to come under RTI. So this should have been a very open and shut case. Open and shut case means you killed someone, you shot them point blank, there is a video. So obviously you are going for life sentence or you are going to be hanged. It is so simple, Jessica Lal murder case was a open and shut case. But unfortunately, because of lawyers and legal complexities, it did not become open and shut case, but it got prolonged. So this should have also been an open and shut case. So does the apex court not preach to others about transparency and openness? So indeed it often has done. So how is it not practicing what it preaches by being exempt from RTI? So it is complicated. So as we know, the RTI was implemented in 2005. So court says that it is complicated, and this act of 2005 was there to bring transparency and ensure accountability in the administration. So what has happened was that in 2009, an RTI was filed in Supreme Court Central Public Information Officer seeking the collegium's notes on the appointment of the judges. So how do you appoint the judges and all this detail was required. This RTI was denied by Public Information Officer, and the person then approached the Chief Information Officer. So obviously this is the logical hierarchy which any individual will follow. So interesting thing here was that the conflict between the Central Information Commission and the Supreme Court. So the Central Information Commission even allowed the appeal. But then the Supreme Court took the case directly to itself and gave a very interesting judgment. Now please see this, okay. Supreme Court divided itself into two parts. One is administrative branch, which would be appealing against the Central Information Commission's decision to allow the RTI, and other is the judicial branch which would hear the appeal. So this was done as this case was unique in itself, that Supreme Court was hearing a case in which its own administration was the appellant. So can you see the irony? So the same person is the appellant and same person is the judge. So finally it overturned the Central Information Commission's verdict. So Supreme Court's verdict overturned the Central Information Commission's verdict. Now let us see Supreme Court on RTI. What does they say? So Supreme Court has recommended to the government that so far as the Supreme Court is concerned, the decision of the registrar general of the court will be final. So decision of the registrar general of the court is final and not subject to any independent appeal to Central Information Commission. Okay, it is a very big step. Further, Supreme Court said that the Chief Justice should have the unfettered right to prohibit the disclosure of any information. You are not allowed to disclose any information whatsoever, which in his opinion might compromise the independence of the judiciary. Okay. Then the Chief Justice has already gone on record to say that even the disclosure of income and assets by judges or the formation of any independent disciplinary authority over judges would compromise the independence of the judiciary. So they can't disclose their income, they can't disclose their assets, there should not be any independent disciplinary authority also over judges, otherwise it will compromise the independence of the judiciary. Now Supreme Court also said, ruled against the transparency in two other RTI matters which were concerning the judiciaries. Okay, so first was that while hearing an appeal against a Delhi High Court division bench judgment, it set aside a CIC verdict that mandated the Supreme Court to disclose information about cases in which judgment has been reserved. And the bench, what happened in that case, it did not furbish any reason whatsoever for dismissing this appeal. So this was the first thing. Now second was that Supreme Court recently refused to interfere with the Delhi High Court's verdict, dismissing a plea seeking details of medical reimbursement of Supreme Court judges on the ground that it would involve that like citing privacy issues, that invasion of privacy will happen, and so on and so forth. So overall, if you see the entire theme of this discussion is that judges apparently are resisting the implementation of RTI Act in higher judiciary. So finally, the point is the opposition justified? So now let us see, is this opposition justified? So argument for opposition of RTI is that the credibility of the judge is at stake. So for judges, their credibility and reputation obviously is very important, and many of the experts feel that the slightest potential slight on this, it can be debilitating and it can prevent judges from doing their job. So credibility of judges is obviously important. Another problem is that collegium system is not transparent. I have already made a video on collegium system, and to a certain extent its opaqueness has to be maintained, as the collegium discussions can be free and frank, and they can include the discussions of courtroom, corridor gossip and judges' private lives, and the examination of fairly invasive government intelligence reports, expression of judges' personal opinions. So otherwise they think that they will not be able to express them. So this sort of openness within the collegium is deemed desirable, but if this information comes out, then this free and frank discussion will not be able to happen. Okay, so let us see the reasons for supporting it. So arguing in favor of bringing judiciary under RTI is obviously, in a democracy, we the people are the supreme. So all the institutions including the judiciary must be transparent and accountable. Secondly, like, high confidence in public has to be there, that the functioning of the courts, which at times is questionable. So justice should not only be done but also seen to be done. So this is to increase the confidence and fairness of judiciary. The lack of stringent in-house accountability and transparency mechanism has allowed the judiciary to keep itself free from regular public scrutiny. So Right to Information Act will be a step forward towards opening a closed and secretive judicial system. And finally, Parliament is supreme. Constitution of India empowers the Parliament to make laws, and the law has to be same for all unless some contingencies demand that certain exceptions are created. For example, Indian Army will not reveal their plans on how to attack the enemies. But the judiciary, by the very virtue of the function it performs, power it holds and the responsibility it has, so it has a lot of responsibility towards the Constitution and the people, and judiciary should uphold itself to the highest possible standards of moral integrity, transparency and accountability. So what is the way forward? So way forward is to implement RTI in its entirety as it is supposed to be in the Act of 2005, and then create exceptions for sensitive information, sensitive case like Nirbhaya case, discussions regarding cases, delivery of justice. Only in those specified cases the Chief Justice may be given the discretion to block the petition for RTI. And the very system of appointment of judges need to be reformed. It should be made transparent. And the problem of non-implementation of RTI in higher judiciary stems from the Supreme Court's unwillingness to open up the collegium system's deliberation. So as you might be knowing that they have scraped the NJAC. And a transparent and credible system of appointment of judges will go a long way in removing this obstacle. Then finally, you have Judicial Accountability Bill. It is another possible mechanism. So mechanism must be derived such that transparency and independence of judiciary both are maintained. And transparency and accountability is always good for others, but for the court and judges, in their case, transparency would compromise their independence. So this is one of the argument. So they always say that independence of the judiciary is always paramount. And do you know that not even an FIR can be registered against judges for any offense without the prior written permission of the Chief Justice of India? On top of all this, they enjoy the power of contempt, where they can send any person who accuses any judge to jail. So the way forward has to be more transparency. So thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day.